Let's break down the create formula, starting with the first element, the character. The character defines the prompters and the AI's roles throughout the entire conversation. Here's an example, where we build a character for the AI as well as ourselves. This gives the AI a persona to embody, ensuring the responses are tailored specifically for our character and use case. It's a way of telling the LLM, think and respond like this, ensuring the output we get is precisely what we'd expect from someone working in that role. The next element of our create formula is the request. Here, we precisely state the AI's tasks, and we want to be as specific and clear as possible. Clarity leads to more targeted and useful outputs. Here's an example of us being very specific with the AI. We're breaking down each aspect of the task at hand, being very intentional with our words to ensure the AI understands us and our needs. However, words can only do so much, and examples are the next element of our formula, and they play a crucial role in ensuring the AI's output aligns with our vision. We use examples to enhance the descriptiveness of our request and give the AI a baseline to compare its responses to. We can give LLMs actual examples of the output, summaries of external resources, and upload files from our knowledge bases so long as we have the permission to do so. In addition to using examples to supplement our requests, we can also use adjustments. This aspect of the formula refines the AI's tasks and includes additional constraints and notes any other considerations for the LLM. We can have the AI ignore something or have it tackle a task with a certain flair or tone. Remember, always be specific. Once we thoroughly explain the AI's tasks, we then move on to the next piece of our formula and describe the types of output we're looking for. Here, we describe how we want the response presented to us, whether it's a 500-word summary of a meeting, highlighting key takeaways, and listing action items for each attendee in a table format, or a simple bulleted list, organizing dependencies. Specifying the output format greatly helps to ensure the AI's responses are aligned with the reason we're using it in the first place. You'd be surprised at how innovative the AI can get at tailoring its output format for us. Look at these examples of Gantt charts, tables, pictures, matrices, lists, calendars, registries, databases, CRMs, and file structures. With the proper direction, you can get generative AI models to output a plethora of different formats to make your life easier. The last piece of our create formula are the extras and evaluation criteria. These serve to provide ways for the LLM to evaluate its output by comparing it against your performance indicators or other objective evaluation measures. You're now equipped with the create formula to harness the power of AI. Remember that you're going to be iterating and adapting aspects of the prompt to get your desired outputs, and they're not always going to be reusable. For every scenario, task, or problem that you present to an AI model, you will always be refining your prompts. In the next video, we're going to compare prompts built using the RTF and create formulas to see how a more advanced prompt formula improves AI responses. Thank you so much for watching. Want the full course? You'll have access to all module videos, more prompting techniques, over a dozen use case and demonstration videos from our PM community, the Prompt Engineering for Project Managers workbook, and so much more. You can find the link to the course in the description below.